whistle, and here he comes on one of his solo runs, chased by Dennis Bernard. But this time, Sean does not score. Galway are not disturbed by this setback and come back attacking once more. And watch for Jerry Kerwin and this Galway point. Frank Ivers back to Sean Purcell, and the Tume sharpshooter makes no mistake as halftime approaches, with Galway leading 2 goals and 6 points to Cork's 6 points. And there's somebody in a hurry, maybe heading to these satisfied customers. Aidan Swords checks in for the restart, and once again it's Jerry Kerwin coming through. He passes to Stockwell. Stockwell is opposed by Donie Sullivan, but the little lad doesn't seem to worry as he sends it over the bar for another Galway point. Jackie Coyle, and a point for Galway. Frank Ivers, and yet another point. And perhaps the danger has gone for Galway. Yes, perhaps. Neil Fitzgerald leads an attack, slips the ball to Toots Keller, and it sizzles to the top of the net. But back comes Coyle and relieves the situation for the Westerners. Oh, those fingers. With 6 minutes to go, Sean Purcell's free hits the upright, comes back into the parallelogram, and Paddy Tyers clears. Yes, time ticking away, and Galway going further ahead. And so, at the final whistle, Galway 2-13, Cork 3-7. The crowd cheering their heroes off. The crowd going home happy and satisfied. But truly, the happiest man in Croke Park, Galway's captain, Jack Mangan, with the Sam Maguire Cup received from Seamus McDonald.